Mr. President, Foreign Minister France.
Hello, President. Well, it's good to see you again.
Thank you very much.
The Ambassador of France.
Yes, hello there.
Mr. Richard.
Yes, President.
Hello.
Hi, how are you? Hello there.
Morning, Father Thomas.
Well, come in. I know we only have a few minutes. If the chair over there.
Morning.
Morning. Nice to see you.
Hi, Mr. Ambassador.
Morning, sir.
Raimond, thank you.
The only man in the room that dressed for today's weather.
Well, you know, it's always a sincere blue that you wear.
Well, it's good to see you again. Vice President Cobey had a conversation with you, but I think you're often very right.
Thank you very much indeed. And I have a message on behalf of the President of the French Republic and of the Italian Church.
Well, give you my regards.
Thank you, Mr. President. Seven long years of debate over the deficiencies of the 1968 gun bill, and I commend you all for your perseverance sticking with this. Must be gratifying to you members of the House, and had to get 218 signatures to for a discharge petition in order to bring this landmark bill to the floor and finally here to my desk. And I think we're all aware of the circumstances that led to the 1968 bill, the tragic circumstances. And I think, however, we have the right to and the responsibility to protect the rights of law-abiding citizens without diminishing the effect of criminal law enforcement. And I think this bill does that. So now I'm going to sign the bill. But these pens, they only write one word.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. Thank you very much. Thanks for your help.
Well,
I appreciate it. Remember your talk, General.
Very pleased. I feel safer.
I'm particularly pleased because some people assume once you have been shot, you might change your mind.
One had nothing to do with the other.
In fact, I've used him on that occasion as a classic case for the other. I don't know of any stricter gun laws in the world than in the District of Columbia, and there he was in broad daylight, 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Blasting away.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much.
Thanks for your time.
You did a lot of work.
Glad for your help.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Help of everybody else here. The team effort.
Thank you.
Big John help without talking.
Getting those signatures in the house.
Right.
Mr. President.
Help get that. Really help get those 218.
Thanks again.
We're like hard shots.
I got told Jim, the trouble is.
We're still working on the other.
Nate, this is Burrell and Keilie. This is Keilie.
And this is Keilie.
That's Keilie.
Better get back here soon.
You guys get closer to the president, right?
She's only gonna look at the cameras. You can see it, right? Keilie, do you know that you have a very loving pair of parents? She's not. Well, I'm so pleased this turned out so well. And I have to say, the senator and his staff, bless them.
They're wonderful.
Yeah.
And we think you're the wonderful, too.
Well, they were the ones that got everything started.
Well, he's brought your choice of a hat, or I get the other ones.
Well, it's from her work, so she.
Oh, it's okay.
You get a choice.
That's our little tater there.
Yeah, I'll just stick.
Well, I don't see any choice there.
It's pretty good. We'll just both take one of those.
Okay. All right.
All right. That's great. Well, I'm so glad they got a chance to see it. Yeah. He's really made the difference on this, and we just want you to know he's such a good
yeah.
Just a wonderful human being. But your baby looks so cute that day. Just wonderful. Okay, well, Mr. President, thank you. Thank you again.
Thank you.
Thanks for meeting
with me. Oh, nice to meet you. Thanks so much, too.
We'll get you some of these pictures.
Okay, thanks.
Yes. Thanks, Brad.
Another
one. Yeah, the child died.
Yeah.
9 months old. Well, I guess that could go to the museum. Well.
Mr. President, Congressman Bill Young.
Yes. Looks like he's got a.
William Young. There.
Hello, Mr. President. How are you? Nice to see you.
This is Beverly. Yes, hi, Beverly.
This is Billy and Robbie.
Hello.
How are you?
Shake hands, sunshine.
How are you?
He's got a family picture.
We'd love to. We would love to.
Can we have you over by the president?
Shall I hold him up?
Stand over by the president? That's great.
Shall I hold him up, do you think?
Yes, that would be better.
Okay.
There.
You want to shake hands with the president, such an honor?
No, he just wants to look at the camera.
Could we do one with Beverly standing by him?
Sure.
Right.
Absolutely, you bet. Well, it's nice to visit with you and
good to see you.
Less formal basis than my wife had more to meet you. I want to tell you one story. You called her on the telephone one time after you got a letter from her.
Yes.
And you called her at home and talked with her about her mother who has passed away.
That was 3 years ago.
Yeah.
3 years, you can't say anything when you're around him, did you?
I know.
Listen, you know, he's been a great help.
Yeah, we are proud of him. Did you tell him how exciting it was?
Come on, sunshine.
Yeah, you can't tell
me. Yes, you can. Just speak right up.
Just tell him. God bless you, Mr. President.
Tell him, Billy. He's been all the way over saying, God bless you, Mr. President.
Well, for heaven's sakes.
We finally got him to say, stop saying God bless you, Ron. Okay, let's go on.
Here you go, Bill.
Thanks, sir.
Okay.
Mr. President, Congressman Bill Cobey of North Carolina.
Hi, how are you? Mr. President, great to see you. Thank you for seeing us today.
Mrs. Strang, come on.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Hi.
See you again, Mr. President.
Dr. Ellen Masolia.
Dr. Ellen Masolia.
As a child, I always wanted to shake the hands of the president. Now, as a senior citizen, I'm glad that I'm shaking hands with one of the finest.
Well, thank you very much. You're very kind.
Thank you.
Congressman Ed Towns.
Ed Towns, how are you? Good to see you.
Now, I understand that we've got four copies of the proclamation over here. That's a great one. And you, I understand, were the inspiration that started. 86 being the year of the flag.
Daughter of an immigrant and loves the flag, knows all about it.
Army wife.
Sometimes I think all of you can lecture all the rest of us native born on real love for America.
That's right.
Well, I should come over here and sign the fort. Affection for our flag was probably different than that of anyone in any other country. And he said he believed that it was because in other countries they had symbols like, well, for example, royalty and so forth. But here the flag of ours had, from the very beginning, had taken the place of all that. But I know back my first, well, I've always kind of gotten a lump in the throat about it. President Nixon once sent me, when I was governor of California, they sent me four times on trips around the world to various countries representing him for certain specific things. So there I was, the president's representative. And I remember in Australia once, well, when you'd come back to the airport after being in those countries, and I'd never had much experience abroad, and then there you'd see on the tail of that Air Force One, you'd see that American flag. And yeah, you choke up a little. But I remember we were in Australia, and it was a time when we were being boycotted with regard to the oil, you know, when we were boycotted by the Arab oil producers and so forth. And we were leaving Australia, and we were flying on to Indonesia, and we were supposed to refuel at a country in between. And then the word came that these countries were going to refuse to refuel us because of the Arab boycott, afraid that they would get in trouble themselves. And it seems that some diplomat along the line suggested that they paint the flag out, cover it up on the tail of the plane so we could be refueled. And I didn't know how much power, just as the representative of the president, I might have there. But I remember saying that we won't go to that.
So that takes that.
I found out that, I don't know whether anybody else, but the crew of the airplane loved it. But we didn't have to.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. President. Glad to see you again.
Good to see you. And thank you.
Thank you. And I hope you add Father's Day to the federal flag list of special thanks. That's a special request for the year of the flag.
See how we do that.
Yeah, all right. Thank you, Mr. President. Good to see you. Thank you so much.
Great to see you, Mr. President.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yes. How are you, sir? Nice to see you again.
Good to see you.
Mr. President, this saddle was made in honor of your second election to the presidency by a guy named Buck Proffitt. Was cut up all by hand, Says, Mr. President, from 1980 to 1988, Ronald Reagan, there's the name, there's the literature, which I'll give you a stamp.
Oh, good. And does this...
He hoped you would take this to your ranch and put it in your saddle room as a souvenir.
That's where it will go, but is his address in here?
This is all in here. It's all in here. And he's just, he's been trying 2 years to give it to you. And he said, you don't know how hard it is to give the president anything. But
I think this is wonderful.
I thought, and I thank your staff, by the way, for making him.
Listen, that's quite a job, yes.
Thank you very much.
As you can see, we kind of go for Western
things. I know you do. This is terrific.
This is great. Walter Hannaford has just loaned those to the White House. The artist that is a history of the Western saddle.
Look at that thing. That's a side saddle.
See, is that the one?
That's a side saddle.
One side saddle. They begin with a Spanish war saddle in the year 1500, but then from that has come all the Western.
I think it's great. Well, I hope you enjoy that, and this old boy is a heck of a saddle maker.
I got it. Well, we'll send him one of
those. Thanks an awful lot. I appreciate it. Good luck. Appreciate it.
You bet. How about that? That's really. Can't wait to put that in the tack room.
I just want to know one thing. How's the gift unit going to appraise something like that? There's probably not another one around. Usually they call around to these different places to find out what things are worth, art galleries or whatever, but
I don't think there's very many of those around.
Pardon me?
How are you going to get it on Lucky?
I was going to say, you know, why try to put this on Lucky? See what it, what would it, with them? Let's put in the stuff to go to the ranch.
I'll put it in the corner.
Or I'll take it upstairs and put it in my
we'll
bag.
We'll take it. Kathy will take care of it.
Right.
Well, that took some time to do, didn't it? My God.
Oh, yeah. That's a real job of saddle making. Oh. Yep. Here's his address. Well, I think we should... How quickly will we have...
We have one for you in the morning, if you'd like.
Oh, boy. We'll send him a picture.
Good idea.